Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about the mechanism of action of anti-Parkinson drug. Now, if you see about this neurodegenerative disorder, already we have told about the what is neurodegenerative disorder, what is the pathogenesis involved into the Parkinsonism disease and Alzheimer disease. So that portion I will not going to go again, but just for a recall, what is neurodegeneration? It is a progressive loss of structure or function of the neurons, including the death of neurons. And due to this condition, due to the neurodegeneration, the disease which is caused, there is called as a neurodegeneration. And there is a number of the neurodegenerative disorder is there. Now in your syllabus, mainly we are going to focus on the Parkinson's disease and the Alzheimer disease. And what is the difference between this? Parkinson's disease, mainly it is due to the imbalance between the cholinergic system, which is excitatory, and the inhibitory system, that is the dopaminergic system. So there is an imbalance. So there is affecting the movement. So dopaminergic system is decreasing, or you can say that there is an imbalance between the dopaminergic or cholinergic system. Now here, and in case of the Alzheimer disease, it is the due to the loss of the memory function. So as we have discussed the pathogenesis next last class, so we'll discuss about the what are the different drugs are there. Now these are the different classification of the drugs affecting dopaminergic system, like dopamine precursor levodopa, peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor carbidopa, dopaminergic agonist bromocriptine, MAO-B inhibitor selexinin, COMT inhibitor entacapone, NMDA glutamate type antagonist or the dopamine facilitator, this is the amantadine. And drugs affecting the cholinergic system. So here, central cholinergic drugs, these are the trihexaphenidyl and antihistaminic drug like promethazine. Now, here if you need to understand that whenever we are talking about this drug, mainly what we have discussed that cholinergic system, there is an imbalance between the cholinergic system and dopaminergic system. Dopamine is less, cholinergic is more. So what is should be the treatment approach? Either you increase the dopaminergic system so there will be the balance, or in that case dopaminergic is less and cholinergic is more, reduce the cholinergic system. So there is a two type of approach is there. So in the second type of the drug, central anticholinergic. Anticholinergic already we have studied. Separate chapter was there. We have discussed there how the anticholinergic it is acting, and you have the separate subclass also anti-Parkinson drugs there. So that I will not going to discuss it again. Already we have covered. Antihistaminic, these are the type of the drug in the various chapter we have discussed that, like promethazine and other thing. They having the antihistaminic, they act on the H1 receptor, but what is their capacity? They can also act as a anticholinergic. They're as a anticholinergic. So this is also one of the effects. So that these are the drug, it is actually, you can say that, reducing the cholinergic system. Whereas drug affecting into the dopaminergic systems, they are increasing the dopaminergic. That means dopaminergic, we know that there is a 5 different type of the receptor, D1 to D5, and D2 is here, it is important, which is the actually inhibitory activity. Now we'll see about the drugs. Now we know that dopamine precursor is the levodopa. Now why we cannot give the dopamine directly? What is the, because if the insulin deficiency we are giving the insulin, then why not the dopamine? The main problem is that dopamine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. This is the one of the important things. They cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. Whereas levodopa, they are easily able to cross the blood-brain barrier. And levodopa is a precursor. So levodopa, dopamine synthesis, it will take place from the levodopa as they are crossing the blood-brain barrier. So we'll see about that. Now, this is a general, you can say that, a diagrammatic representation, what it is there. If you find it here, levodopa in presence of, this is in periphery, this is inside the brain, this is the blood brain barrier. So levodopa in presence of COMT, catechol O methyl transferase. Catechol O methyl that will convert into the 3O methyl dopa. Levodopa again in presence of dopa decarboxylase, it will converting into the dopamine in the periphery. But this dopamine cannot cross the blood brain barrier. They cannot cross the blood brain barrier. So levodopa it will cross the blood brain barrier. And generally, what is the synthesis of dopamine? Because it is also a neurotransmitter in the brain. So tyrosine, in presence of the tyrosine hydroxylase, it will convert into the levodopa. Levodopa it will convert into the dopamine in presence of dopa decarboxylase. So this dopamine it will be present inside the vesicle because it is a neurotransmitter. So it will present into the vesicle, and whenever there will be the exocytosis, it will be released into the synapse. Then again dopamine in presence of COMT, it will may converting into the 3-methoxytyramine and then using the MAO-B, homovalenic acid. MAO-A, wherever you have studied, in case of the adrenergic system, noradrenaline biosynthesis. Next is dopamine, again in place of the MAO-B, it will be converting into the dihydroxyphenyl acetic acid, and then through COMT, it is converting into the homovalenic acid. Levodopa with the COMT 3O methyl dopa, and some amount of the dopamine again they will go inside the presynaptic neuron, that is the transport of the dopamine into the presynaptic neuron like that of the other neuron. So this is the general thing. So lower levodopa if you are giving, they will go here, they will cross the blood brain barrier and they will synthesize the levodopamine. What is the problem? Problem is, after giving the levodopa, only 5% of levodopa can cross the blood-brain barrier and they will be converting into the dopamine. But 95% of the levodopa, they will be destroyed before it will convert into the dopamine in the CNS, in the brain. So this is the function of the levodopa. And dopamine here, they will act on the D2 receptor. Already we have told D2 receptor. Now levodopa. Next is peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor, like carbidopa type of the drug. What they will do? Peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor. That means they will not going to cross the blood-brain barrier. They will act only on the periphery. They are going to act on the periphery. What their function? They will inhibit the dopa decarboxylase. If the dopa decarboxylase inhibiting, what will happen? Conversion of the levodopa to dopamine in periphery. In periphery, they will be not there. So more amount of the levodopa, it will go inside the brain. So this is the function of the peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor. Here, COMT inhibitor, catechol O methyl transferase. Catechol O methyl transferase, again they will inhibit into the periphery. They will inhibit the breakdown of the levodopa and the dopamine also in the brain. So ultimately what happened? More amount of the levodopa, it will cross the blood-brain barrier. That means what? Either it is the inhibitor of the dopa decarboxylase or it is the inhibitor of the COMT, they are give along with the levodopa. So more amount of the levodopa, it will cross the blood-brain barrier and dopamine synthesis, it will take place. So again, here it is going to bind. Here it is going to bind. So COMT it is there. So more amount of the dopamine, it will be synthesis. More amount of the dopamine, it will be available into the synapse. So that is the function of this COMT inhibitor. Next is MAO-B inhibitor. MAO-B inhibitor like selenium, they will be going to inside the brain and they will inhibit the MAO-B. If they are inhibiting the MAO-B here and here, what will happen? Breakdown of the dopamine, it will be inhibited. There will be less breakdown of the dopamine. So more dopamine, it will be available and they will going to act on the dopamine receptor. So that is the beneficial thing. So dopamine, it will act on the D2 receptor. Next is dopaminergic agonist. So this is important. Dopaminergic agonist. Dopaminergic agonist means bromocriptine. Now this particular drug, they can directly able to bind with the D2 receptor. They can able to bind to the directly with the D2 receptor. And they are inducing the inhibition like that of the dopamine. Because dopamine, if it is binding the D2, it will cause the inhibition. So bromocriptine also, it is act as the agonist. We know that agonist means it is act like that of the endogenous substances. So bromocriptine will act like that of the dopamine by binding with the D2 and it will cause the inhibition. Next category of the drug is the amantadine. Now amantadine, it is actually antiviral drug. It is developed as an antiviral drug, but later on it was found that this amantadine having the very good activity in case of the Parkinson's disease also, and it is terms as a facilitator. Now what they are doing, say dopamine facilitator, amantadine, they are increase the release of the dopamine, they increase the release of the dopamine, so thus exercise, so more dopamine it will be available in the synapse. So ultimate, if you see that all the way, ultimate goal is to increase the level of the dopamine in the synapse, in the brain synapse. And also the some amount of the dopamine, again it will go back inside the neuron, so that particular process, that particular steps also inhibited by the amantadine. So more amount of the dopamine is present here, whereas amantadine also it is as the antagonistic effect on the NMDA type of glutamate receptor. Glutamate receptor, it is what, this excitatory, so it is inhibiting that antagonistic, so antagonistic activity it is there. So this is the amantadine. So if we see about now, look into the all picture, levodopa, it will go inside the brain and it will dopamine synthesis, it will promote the dopamine synthesis. Next is levodopa to dopamine, they will increase, you can say that peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor. Clear? Peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor, they are inhibiting the dopa decarboxylase. So more amount of the levodopa, it will go inside the brain. COMT inhibitor, again they will cause the inhibit the breakdown of the levodopa, so that from periphery more amount of the drug, it will levodopa, it will go inside the brain. And here also COMT, it is inhibiting the breakdown of the levodopa as well as the dopamine. So what will happen, more amount of the dopamine it will be available. In case of the MAO-B inhibitor, they are going to again inhibit the breakdown of the dopamine in the synapse. Clear? In the synapse, so dopamine breakdown it will be inhibited, so more amount of the dopamine it will be available. So that is the MAO-B. Next is bromocriptin, dopaminergic agonistic type of the drug. What they will do, they will act on the D2 receptor, and after acting on the D2 receptor, they will facilitate, they will act like that of the dopamine, they will inhibit, they will, you can say that inhibit the effect, inhibitory effect, they will produce the inhibitory effect. But in case of the amantadine, they act as a dopamine facilitator. Now dopamine, they will increase the release of the dopamine, they will inhibit the neuronal reuptake of the dopamine, as well as they will also act, means they having the antagonistic effect on the NMDA type of glutamate receptor. Clear? NMDA type of glutamate. So these are the different types of the drugs which are available, and that is the mechanism of action of this type of the drug. Now here you need to remember that, say here amantadine increase the dopamine, levodopa it is act as a precursor, COMT and MAO inhibitor, they do not have their own effect, then you can say that they will be helpful to, you can say that whenever it is given along with the levodopa. Bromocriptin, of course it will directly acting like that of the dopamine. So these are the different drugs mechanism of action. So I think you have understood. Thank you. If any doubt, we can discuss.